All right, so what I'd like to do is work up to a proof that k-means does something good. And to do that, I think it's helpful to have a little bit more precise notation than what I was doing before. So here we go. We're going to work up to doing k-means in a Euclidean space. And the notation that I'm going to use is we've got at any given moment in time in the algorithm, there's some partition p super t of x. And these clusters are defined the same way that we did before, which it just returns the, you know, some kind of identifier for what cluster X is in. And this is at iteration T of k-means. We also have another kind of more convenient way of writing that, which is C sub I of T, which is the set of all points in cluster I. It's really just the same as the set X such that P of X equals I. Does that make sense?
Yeah, okay, that makes perfect sense. You've got some kind of partition, and everything in the same partition belongs together in something you're calling C for cluster.
Good. And we're also going to need to be able to refer to the center of a cluster. Because we're in a Euclidean space, it's meaningful to add the objects together. So take all the objects that are in some cluster Ci at iteration T and divide by the number of objects in that cluster. So just summing those points together. This is also sometimes called the centroid, right?
Right. So it's the mean or the centroid.
Yeah, it's like a, that's right. I mean, in one dimension, it's definitely the mean. In higher dimensions, it's like a per dimension mean.
Oh, so in fact, you're going to end up with K means.
Oh, I see what you did there.
Mm.
So now here's an equation arrow version of the algorithm that we start off picking centers in some way for iteration zero, and we hand it over to this process that's going to assign the partitions. In particular, the partition of point X is going to be the minimum over all the clusters of the distance between X and the center of that cluster. All right, so it's just assigning each point to its closest center. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm. And that all those bars with the sub 2 just mean Euclidean distance.
Yeah, we're just, that's right, exactly. We're just computing the distance between those two things. And we hand that partition over to the process that computes the center. So it's now using this other representation of the clustering, Ci. It's adding the points together, dividing by the number of points in that cluster, and it hands those centers back to this first process to recompute the cluster. So we're just going to be ping-ponging back and forth between these two processes.
Okay.
Good?
Sure, and T keeps getting updated after every cycle.
Right. Yeah, so this is where T gets incremented, T++. So this is the algorithm, and an interesting fact about it is, do you remember when we talked about optimization?
I do remember when we talked about optimization.
And optimization is good because it's finding better and better answers. So if we can think of this as being kind of an optimization algorithm, then that could be good. It could be that, that what we're doing, what we're going around here, is not just randomly reassigning things, but actually improving things.
Okay, well, how are you going to convince me of that?
All right, let's do that.